because why not? Whew. Hi guys, this is Connie. I'm gonna do some Connie reads because I still didn't finish chapter 30. I'm exhausted and it feels like from doing nothing, which is not entirely accurate. I kept the baby alive, which is important. Wow, I feel like I got like this hidden heart thing going on here. But a part of me almost said, I do want to go to sleep when the baby goes to sleep. And I know that Mustachio just put the baby down. But I also know if I don't do these chapters, I'm not going to end up catching up with where you guys need it to be before I have to renew this book or turn it back in again. So that's a thing. It's Northern Virginia. It's raining a lot this week. Just lots and lots of rain. Trying to think of what I was gonna say. I'm in that mommy black hole that feels like I want to take my child to some sort of daycare so that I can feel like a normal human being. I'm really excited that I'm probably gonna start doing that when I go to the gym occasionally, because they give you 2 hours maximum when you watch them. I'm like, yes, I can swim, I can breathe, I can put my arms behind my back and stretch it out without having to hold my baby. It's Wednesday. It's only Wednesday. It's the 17th? Yeah, 17th now, I think. Haven't done any of my daily, I guess I should do that real quick. I'm thinking about like the check-ins and the things that I do on my phone. And I've done the bare minimum. I think today's the first day my baby has tried Cheetos. And we're talking like less than an entire Cheeto in total, because she chewed about half of it in little bits and pieces. And then by the time it was all said and done, she kind of went, and it all came out afterwards, which is always lots of fun. Looking forward to spending some quality time with Mustachio because he is awesome. But I hate that once the baby goes down, it happened once last week where Mustachio took the baby and suddenly I felt this like burst of energy. I've got to get something done. And I like clean swept all the way through the living room, which proceeded to now have more graham crackers and toys all over it again. So that's a thing. I'm thinking about taking my kid to some babysitter or daycare center so that I can actually try to clean the house. Because no matter where we go and no matter what we do, I feel like everywhere I turn, there is some project to be done in this house. There's just, I could do this with this closet. Today I did the closet, the jacket closet downstairs, the broom closet, jacket closet, whatever you want to call it. That closet got done. I already took 2 bags of donatables to the Salvation Army, only to find 2 more bags of books on CDs that I'm going to end up having to take, if not tomorrow, then some other time. I took 1 or 2 things up to the baby's room to put in her closet. So it's baby stuff. Just put it in the baby's closet. Why not? Why not?
Hello, Yoda.
I don't think he's regularly been in my vlogs since we were in the apartment. So 3 years ago. Fun stuff. I was still wearing my wedding dress occasionally in those vlogs. So that's a fun thing. I will do my best to get on my computer. My problem is I just continue to go down a rabbit hole when I go to do things. And then I get more and more tired. And then I don't end up going to sleep until almost 10 or 11 o'clock at night, which I would rather not do. I'm getting solid sleep, but I'm getting like solid 6 or 7 hours of sleep. And I still want to sleep during the day. So a part of me goes, I wonder if I start winding down right after the baby goes to sleep, Maybe I'll actually feel refreshed in the morning. Maybe. Possibly. I don't know. It's always a wonderful theory and thought. There's so many things we want to teach her. We want to get back into sleep training because we fell out of that a while ago. At this point, now that she's one, I'm supposed to be, like, introducing foods, like, more solid type foods or soft foods. And she's still on a bottle. Like, she loves her formula, and we've now been adding milk. We've been doing half formula, half milk recently. But I also noticed that she does not hold her own bottle because we've not told her to do that. Whereas now, she holds her own she's been holding her own pacifier for months now. When we give her a Wubba Nub, she knows exactly how to soothe herself. What she doesn't know is how to feed herself, other than doing the baby-led weaning thing, which she kinda does okay. So yeah, just lots of weird things all about my child. I think this time last week, I was slowly losing my mind. About 2 weeks ago, I don't mind saying it now because I feel like I've gotten out of that funk and I'm in a whole new one now. I have a new one that goes with my hair. About 2 weeks ago, I was ready to give up. And by give up, I mean I was seriously contemplating, like, running away and not being my adult self, not being a wife, not being a mommy. And I was just like, really? Really? You're gonna pick up, you're gonna leave this life and pick up and try and start a whole new life? Really? 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 Your life is not an episode of episodes. Duh. And sharing various frustrations with other mommies and people and just having adult conversations with actual adults was incredibly refreshing to know that I'm not the only one that's felt that way before. And it just gave me an appreciation for where I am and what I'm doing. And while I may be a bit of a screw up, I'm not a total lost cause, and neither is my life. And I say that apart from, like, faith in Christ, which makes me wonder, whoo, my Christian checkup. I'm like, I do have that 150-day streak on my Bible app, but if I'm not applying the scriptures that I'm finding on my Bible app every day, there's a bit of a problem and a hiccup in it. Not to mention, just because life and distractions and losing focus, I don't think I've listened to the sermon thoroughly at church in the last 3 weeks. And we're also planning to go out of town soon. I felt bad I had to, like, cancel plans and stuff. I don't like backtracking and declining on things that I've already made commitments to. But I don't make plans. Like, they send us these emails in our planning center for worship and creative arts, and it makes me want to thoroughly apologize because I don't make plans months in advance. Are you coming down here?
Yeah.
You are? I'm recording. It's the night vlog. You wanna say hello? I was going to finish the chapter before I disappear for the night, and I had this novel idea that I should try and fall asleep right after the baby goes to sleep, because I'm tired too.
Yeah.
I don't want to sleep 10 hours. I don't know if my body needs 10 hours.
Don't worry, you won't sleep 10 hours.
Oh. No, the perfect things to say. So, that's it in a nutshell. So, be careful with that and enjoy.
Please, and thank you.
Bye.